Hello, hello, mic test. Okay, so our paper trade is now ready. Everything is ready. The first order has already been placed. You can see that this is the price of Bitcoin at this time. Bought it price this one, and investment value is this one. Let's wait for the next candle. The next candle has also come. So there are now two Bitcoins that are bought in this paper trading simulator. So yes, you can see that this is very simple now. By just writing this small amount of code, you can actually make trading bot with a paper trading simulator. Hello, financial programmers. I'm Ritvik Dashora and I'm back with a video and some new learnings. This is the third video of this playlist, which is on Bitmart. In the first video, I covered the basic things about Bitmart, which is basically exploring the entire platform. In the second video, I deep dived into the API. I went through the entire API documentations. We have written this particular code, which is in front of you right now, which is basically authenticating it and then extracting all the required information directly from the API. So they have an SDK as well. So I'm just directly using that Python library here, which is bitmart.api. And you can refer to my last video to know more about this. So I'm gonna just continue working on the last video code only. So this is the code that we wrote in the last video, which was basically on extraction of the historical data, right? In this case, we used the function called get symbol kline, and we provided from time to time, and then we extracted data of interval of 1 minute, right? So this was the code. Now we'll be extending this code in this video to make a full-fledged trading bot. But yes, guys, before this, if you're new to my YouTube channel, on this channel, I turn all my viewers to successful financial programmers. Here I upload videos related to trading bots, integration of AI in finance, exploring some highly valuable finance APIs, making some educational Python script trading strategies, or on MT5, etc. So if there's something that you're interested in, then just click on that red button, which is subscribe button, and also hit on the bell icon. It's free for you, but it's really very valuable for me, and I will also provide the same value to you, because there are many more playlists that are coming on this YouTube channel, which is free of cost for you, and you will stay tuned if you just click on that button. So please, guys, just hit on that red button. And without any further ado, let's start. So yeah, in the last video, we made this code. We extracted the data directly of BTC USDT, kline, and so on, right? So the similar thing only I'll do here. I'll just write video 3. What are the libraries that I would be requiring here? Which is the first one is time, and I think that's it. The ticker is btcu_usdt, right? And then I'll just copy and paste these things, which is to time and from time. Import date time as dt. I think I have already done it, but let's do it again. Let's run this, right? Up till here, we, like you guys already know, because I have already covered in the last video. Now from here, the first thing that I'm going to use here is paper trading simulator. For this, I will refer to one of my past videos. I recorded it, I think, a couple of years ago, and it was specifically on how to make a paper trading simulator. If you guys have not watched that video, I highly recommend you guys to watch that video as well. I have covered each and every aspect of making paper trading simulator in that video. So I'm gonna just use that code directly, although I'll just give a brief explanation here as well. But again, if you would like to know more about it, just watch that video. It's not very long. The link of that video is in the description box. So this is the code that I just copied and pasted. So I'm starting with an amount of 1 million, right? The portfolio value is zero. What is portfolio value? Basically the total amount which is inside the portfolio right now. So right now, because we have not yet started, it's zero in the beginning. Money end is basically the amount that we are using for this trading purpose. So imagine that this is the amount of our bank, right? So it's equal to amount. So it is equal to the entire amount, which is 1 million in our case, right? Investment is a list which will keep on appending, which will keep on extending on the amount or on the total amount that is invested in the security. If the trades do change, for example, if there is a long position already taken, and if we take a short position, which is using the sell function, there will be a new variable which will be attached to this to this list, extending the list, right? The transaction cost in this example, I'm just taking it at 0.75%. These are the two functions, buy and sell functions. Basically, there are two inputs inside it, quantity and price, right? I'm putting portfolio and money and in the global parameters. Basic calculations, the allocated money is quantity multiplied by price. So whenever we buy anything, it will be quantity multiplied by price only, right? The money end, which is the money which will be remaining in our bank account, the pseudo bank account in our example, which will be equal to money end, which is the initial amount minus allocated money, because this amount has been used to buy the security, minus transaction cost, right? The portfolio will gain by quantity, which is one, for example, if we take, if we buy 1 unit. Investment is basically, as I mentioned, it will keep on appending with the allocated money, right? If there is already some investments that are happened, then we'll basically append it accordingly as well. Same goes with the sell function as well. Sell, then inside this, there are two inputs, quantity and price. Portfolio and money are in global parameters. Allocated money is equal to quantity multiplied price. It's exactly the same. Money end is equal to money end plus allocated money minus transaction cost. Why plus? Because we are shorting, right? Portfolio is equal to negative of quantity, right? So because again we are shorting, and then investment is basically the list which keeps on extending, right? As I mentioned. So let me just run this cell. You'll see that we can use these functions directly. So for example, if I just use buy function and then price is say 30,000. So you'll see that the let's see what is the portfolio value now. It should be 1, right? Yeah, because there's a buy position that was taken. Amount should be 1 million minus 30,000 and adjusted with the, okay, amount would be the same only, sorry, money end would be now different, right? So if I just run this money end, it will be 30,000 and then adjusted with the transaction cost as well. That's why it's not exactly minus 30,000, which is also good. Investment is the amount which is now invested, which is 30,000 in our example. Right, and transaction cost is something that we have already figured out. So these are the simple functions that we have created. Let me just run this cell again, and let's delete these things. Now, as I mentioned in the last video as well, we are going to use a for loop here, infinite for loop here, to extract the prices on a real-time basis, and then make a very simple trading strategy, which is not a recommended trading strategy, of course. It's just for educational purpose, and then we'll see if the if you are like placing some orders on the paper trade or not. Just before that, guys, I have a very important information to share. Recently I launched a course on Python for financial programming. So if you are trying to learn Python for finance from scratch, then this is something that you might be interested in. Just go to my website, which is fpritvik.com/python. Over here you will see two buttons, Indian candidates, non-Indian candidates. So you can click as per your location. It will redirect you to this, the main website, where the entire course information is available. You'll see that there are 5 sessions, 10 chapters, 22 videos, 10 quizzes and 3 assignments with 2 live projects. And this is the entire syllabus of this course for all the people who are interested to learn Python from scratch and who are struggling learning Python on their own. I highly recommend it because it's very, very affordable, and I have covered a lot of things from a very, very simplistic eyesight. And in the end, in session 4 and 5, you'll see stock analysis and investment portfolio creation projects, which are my personal projects. We did it using some financial analysis. If you use RTK40 code, you'll get an instant 40% discount, which is only available for the first 100 candidates. So yes, guys, I'll see you in the course. Let's come back to our code. Okay, so for I in range, I'll pick a big range here. Okay, so I've just copied and pasted these things from above. Data is equal to spot API and then K line, and then there's the K line data, as we have done above as well. Let's make our trading strategy something very, very simple. Okay, so it's a very simple strategy. Buy condition, when the current candle close price is greater than the current candle, when the current candle close price is greater than the last candle close price, and the sell condition will be there when the current candle close price is less than the current candle sorry, the last candle close price. So that's very simple. Again, the price is the current candle close price, right? So we'll print it here as well. What else? Buy and sell order, right? If buy condition is equal to true, let's zoom it a bit. Yeah, perfect. If the buy condition is equal to true, then simple, which is buy, let's just do one quantity and price. I have already defined price. I'm printing thing like some of the things as well. Bought at price. I just want to know the price at which we are buying it. And money remaining. What is the amount of money which is remaining in the bank account? The portfolio value, like the number of stocks, the number of bitcoins that we have in the portfolio, and then investment. What is the exposure right now of Bitcoin in the portfolio? Same goes with if sell condition is equal to true, then we'll just write sell one comma price, and other things like sold at price, this one, money remaining, portfolio, and this one, right? Now here I'll just provide time dot sleep in 60 seconds. So I'm just sleeping this for 60 seconds, right? Now let's run this code and let's see if we are actually placing some orders or not. Okay, so our paper trade is now ready. Everything is ready. I have started the code and the first order has already been placed. You can see that this is the price of Bitcoin at this time. Bought at price this one, and investment value is this one. Let's wait for the next candle. The next candle has also come, and you can see there's one more buy condition. So there are now two Bitcoins that are bought in this paper trading simulator. So yes, you can see that this is very simple now, but by just writing this small amount of code, you can actually make trading bot with a paper trading simulator, and this will keep on happening. So I think let's stop this code, and by any chance, if you have not followed this code, it's absolutely fine, guys. My already existing subscribers know that I share my Google Drive access with my community members, the Google Drive community members, and on my Google Drive I have very important things like my personal trading bot, my study materials, some of my personal Pine script strategies which I made for educational purposes only. So you can just just copy and paste everything from my Google Drive to your computer. So how to become a Google Drive community member? Just search financial programming with Ritvik and click on the my channel here. Over here, click on this link which is present just above, just below the name of the channel. If you click here, you can see these are the steps that you can follow to become my Google Drive community member. The cost of my community is very, very small. It's less than a coffee price, and I am quite sure, I can 100% guarantee that the value that I'm providing on my Google Drive is much more than this, and this is how you'll be supporting my channel as well. You can trust me that it's completely worth it. If you liked even one thing about this video, guys, please click on the like button. It's free, but it's very, very important for the algorithm. It will help me to grow on YouTube. Also, write in the comment section about the upcoming topics that you have in your mind. I try to cover all of them. So just mention all of them in the comment section. The next playlist is also going to be very, very special and very important for you guys. I'm not sharing any information right now just to create the suspense. Stay tuned by subscribing to my YouTube channel, and something great is coming. Lastly, if you guys want me to be involved in your personal projects, yes guys, I have a team of 11 experienced professionals now. We do provide freelancing services. Just write me an email on this email address and we'll reach out to you as soon as possible. Last but not the least, the link of my course is in the description section. Please check it out and let me know your feedback. Thank you so much guys for watching this video till the end. You can click here to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Over there you'll see this entire playlist of Bitmart, and over there you'll see my last video of the last playlist, which was on EverTrader MT5 trading bot, and you can actually compare the two trading bots as well. So yes guys, keep learning, keep financial programming. I'll see you in the next video, next playlist, next Saturday, and until then, peace.